Good evening. All four lawsuits accuse the two companies of knowingly endangering people's lives.
From the outside, it's hard to tell any chemicals are used at either Vantage, located in Gurnee, or Medline here in Waukegan. But four lawsuits filed today say both companies have been releasing too much ethylene oxide into the air, a known cancer-causing chemical.
So I found my tumor, my breast cancer tumor, in October of 2014. And I called my doctor. I went. 5 days later, I found out it was a triple negative tumor, which, as you know, is a non-hormonal.
Which means Kathleen Koch's tumor was environmental. She is one of the plaintiffs. She is cancer-free now, but must continually get checked.
When she has to go in for her mammogram and a full blood run to make sure everything's still clear, you hold your breath.
Mark and Kathleen have lived in Gurnee their whole lives. The home they share is just a few miles from the Vantage plant.
When you guys moved here, did you have any idea what they did?
No. I didn't know what they did. I didn't even know they were there.
They now know Vantage is a worldwide chemical company. Both Vantage and Medline, a medical supply company, are named in her lawsuit, and the three others because they're located so close to each other.
These companies have a responsibility to this community, and they have failed in that.
Chris Dorr is one of Kathleen's attorneys. His other clients with pending lawsuits have been diagnosed with a form of leukemia. One is just 3 years old. Dorr points to governmental testing he says shows ethylene oxide emitted from both plants hasn't decreased in any substantial way over the years. Dorr says people who live near the plants have likely contracted deadly diseases and had no idea why.
What they may not have been able to understand or pinpoint a reason for, there may be a reason for it, and it may be these emissions have caused people great health problems.
If all this talk about cancer and ethylene oxide sounds familiar, it's because Sterigenics in Willowbrook was shut down because of its emissions of ethylene oxide. It too is facing a number of lawsuits. While it'll be a while before Kathleen and her husband's case goes before a jury, they have one goal in mind.
Somebody has to be held accountable.
Now, Medline did release a statement tonight saying that it fully complies with all emissions standards and it will fight these lawsuits. Vantage tonight says it is still working on a statement for us. We're live in Waukegan. I'm Eric Rung, WGN News.
Eric, thanks very much.